Sphero Mini is all of the fun of the original Sphero and more, shrunk down into a nice little package. To get you up and running, we put together this mini tutorial. Unboxing is quick and easy. Just slide the clear box containing your Mini out of the top of the package. Then pinch in the sides and pull the base out of the box and pop your Mini off of the pedestal. There is a tiny bit of adhesive holding the Mini in place, so you may have to give it a bit of a tug. Finally, just remove the shrink wrap from your Mini so you can open the shell. Inside the lower part of the package, you'll find a little bag of accessories, a USB cable, and a legal guide. Now to get to the fun part. You'll want to charge your Mini and get the app downloaded. To charge your Mini, squeeze the sides of the outer shell and it will pop open. Plug in the micro USB and a breathing blue light will let you know that your Mini is charging. When the light turns to a solid green, then it's fully charged. While Mini is charging, get out your smart device and download the Sphero Mini app from the App Store or Google Play. Launch the app. First-time users will go through a quick welcome screen. Once through that, simply select your Mini and tap Connect. If you have multiple Minis, you can match up the ID number at the top of the selection with the one on your packaging. You can also star your favorite Mini so it's easy to connect to, or the Mini closest to your device should be the first on the list. First-time users will likely have a firmware update for their Mini. This process should only take a minute or two, and when it's completed, it will send you to the AIM screen by default. Tap and drag the dot until the blue light on the Mini is facing toward you. Aiming tells your bot what direction straight is so that it knows which way to go when you push up on the joystick. You can bring this up anytime to recalibrate if your aim starts to drift by tapping the little reticle in the bottom center of the drive screen. Joystick driving is our most standard control scheme. Simply drag the center blob in the direction you want to go. The further out you drag, the faster Mini will go in that direction. To access the other drive modes, hit the plus button in the bottom left. Tilt drive works exactly how it sounds. Tap the play button to start driving, then just tilt your phone up and down to go forward and back, or tilt to each side to send your Mini in that direction. The more you tilt your phone, the faster Mini will go in that direction. You can pause tilt drive by tapping the pause button. Slingshot mode is great for quick tabletop games. Pull back on the center blob to aim and set power. Remember, the blue light will indicate the back of the Mini, then release to send your Mini shooting forward. Our most unique drive mode is face drive. Select face drive from the drive mode screen and hold your device with the front camera facing you. You will want to aim your Mini before placing your face into the on-screen circle. The video frame will have a pink hue until the system has detected your face. Once it has recognized your face, you can follow the on-screen icons to make Mini drive with different facial expressions. Smile or frown to send Mini forward or back, and tilt your head to the side to send it in that direction. There are a few other expressions that will make your Mini respond, so try experimenting with some goofy facial expressions and see what happens. Driving isn't all you can do with your Sphero Mini. There are a bunch of mini games available in the app that use Mini as a controller. Tap the icon in the bottom right of the screen to launch mini games and scroll through horizontally to see what is available. Each game will begin with a short tutorial to get you up to speed on using Mini as a controller. Exile 2, use Mini to move and shoot spaceships. Lightspeed Drifter. Use Mini to control a futuristic car racing inside a tunnel. The ship can gain speed by running through boost pads, lose speed by hitting obstacles, and collect stars. Keep an eye on the border around the screen as it counts down your current time available. Round trip. Rotate Mini to destroy a polygon of bricks by bouncing a ball against them to score. Last but not least, you can use Mini with the Sphero EDU app to learn how to code and create your own programs that control your Mini. General settings are available via the icon at the top right of the screen. These include volume sliders for sound effects and music, as well as a color selection slider at the top. This allows you to choose the color of the light inside your Mini. Slide it all the way to the right for a white light, or all the way to the left to turn off the light. Teeny tiny tech, packed with play. Sphero Mini makes everything a little more fun.